What's up, my fellow movie collectors? Well, here I'm doing my review on my Predator Hot Toys 1/6 scale figure. But before I get to that, I want to thank Nathan from Dalek Idea Customs for helping me with the intro to my showcase. Nathan, thank you very much. That was so great, man. You know, I talked to you on MSN and I asked you for a favor and you did it, and you did it beautifully, man. It looks awesome, kick ass. Thanks to you, the intro looks just badass. People are enjoying it. And guys, if you don't know who Nathan is, links here on the side to his YouTube page, Dalek Idea Customs, and he's a great, big fan of Doctor Who, and he does amazing stuff, and stop animation is great. So Nathan, thank you very much again, and guys, I hope you guys enjoy my review. Okay guys, let's start the review. We'll start with the base. I love what Hot Toys is doing nowadays with these bases. I call them theme bases, okay, because they try to recreate a scene from the movie in their base. And this is based on the scene when he's about to unmask himself, and the helmet falls on the ground, and water splashes, and you can see there's a little puddle of water there. The effect is, it's great, and it's got a little see-through film of plastic, and it looks like water in the middle there, and it looks fantastic. The rock formation there looks great, good vibrant colors, very live. The plants, you know, here they're plasticky and they look great. You get the trunk here, which has got fine detail on it, and you get a little boulder here in the back, which just adds up so much to the figure. And it compares to the big guys, the Sideshow Maquette and the Cinemaquette. They did the same thing. They had the little bases, you know, with the water and all that, and plants around it and trees, and it works. It worked well for them. So Hot Toys did the same thing, and it's just working perfect. Continuing along here, you get the leggings of the armor, which are completely movie accurate. There's no detail missed there. You get the shin, the knee pads there. And of course, you get the mesh on the legs. And you guys notice the proportion on the legs are more bulkier. And, you know, Hot Toys didn't miss that because, I mean, people complain a little bit that the Wolf Predator was a little bit too skinny on the legs, but, I mean, it was a slimmer Predator. But I mean, no detail was missed here. I love the proportions of the figure. It looks fantastic. And you get the armor piece here, are the hip pieces. And of course you get the crotch piece, and the mixed media, the loincloth here, which is mixed media. It looks fantastic. There's a little pouch here, which looks awesome. I actually had no idea the little pouch was there in the movie, but I mean, now that I know it's there, I looked at the movie and it was there. It's just no detail missed here. More trophies here, just hanging on a little rope. They look fantastic. You get the meshing on the chest piece. Paint applications are unreal. Armor, the chest armor piece with all the little rubber hoses there, one running here to the computer. And of course there's the armor pieces on the shoulders, and all connected with the there is all the leather strapping here that connects to the backpack. And wow, the little tassels here, oh, they kill me. That's such a great touch there. The blade retractable, beautiful design there with the blades, and yes, the beautiful design of this creature done by Stan Winston Studios. Wow, rest in peace, Stan. Of course, and then you get the computer that opens up here, and then it reveals the unforgettable countdown sequence of the movie at the final there when he blows himself up. There is more wiring here, and rubber little wires. And of course, you get the famous shoulder cannon that moves up and down and side to side, and it's had little wires there. It looks unreal detail. And of course, the famous bio helmet, the battle damage bio helmet, which looks so good. You see the mesh on there. The lineup feature is fantastic. Great touch there. The dreads look awesome. Just, oh man, just so lifelike this figure looks. And of course, the famous backpack with the med pack in it, which I'll show in the accessory just shortly. And of course, you get the spinal cord there. Wow, this figure just blows me away every time I see it. And of course, you get the full range of articulation this figure has to offer, and 36 points of articulation. I could be wrong, but it just, you can achieve any pose with this figure. Okay, guys, let's continue with the accessories here. I will start with the non-battle damage Saichu exclusive helmet. It is a nice little helmet, nice addition to the figure. But guys, do not pay any extra for this. It's not worth it. I mean, if to pay... oh my god, I seen a sale on eBay just for this little helmet alone, just to add it up to the figure, for $142. It's completely ridiculous. You guys don't need this. It's a nice helmet, but it has no light-up feature. So that's points down for that. I love the battle damage helmet. It's just so more true to the movie. I love the detail. It just looks so much more natural, okay? And of course, and it brings a light-up feature in it. And there's a little wire here you connect in the back and just kick ass. So don't worry about it if you can't get the exclusive. Moving along here, we get the trophy skull. That looks like Billy's skull, all ripped off. So it looks great, you know, once you get it up posed, you can get some great poses with that on. You get the open the mandibles, the interchangeable mandibles, so you can get the expressions going. You have the fist. Oh, actually, this is the hand to hold the trophy, all right, and or to achieve other poses. And there's the open hand, and there's another open hand over there, so you get two of them, and then you get another fist right there, and you get the other fist back there, okay? And last but not least, there is the med kit that just blows me away. This is so awesome. I remember doing the unboxing, and this piece blew me up. Opens up, closes up, and I mean, it's so cool. It goes in the back, it goes in the backpack, slides in perfectly. Okay, guys, moving to the final part of my review. Helmets off, little wires disconnected from the back, and voila, you get to reveal the amazing head sculpt of the Predator and all his fury there, his eyes, his gaze, just target to, you know, to hunt down Arnold in the final scene of the movie, and the, you know, the expression with the big roar there, and wow. Quick switch of the mandibles, and you get this awesome expression, and I mean, it looks amazing. Head sculpt, the dome here, all the paint applications, just looks dead on to the movie. Wow, unreal. Okay, guys, this is the end of my review on the Hot Toys Predator. And all I gotta tell you is, if you're looking for a great representation, a 1/6 scale representation, and of course, there's always the issue with us collectors of space and money, right? If you're looking for those great attributes in one collectible, this is the collectible to get. I mean, I know the big maquettes are out there, the Sideshow, the Cinemaquette, which are amazing pieces, and of course the one-to-one scale bust, and so many other collectibles for this amazing creature brought to us by Stan Winston Studios. And yes, Kevin Peter Hall was the man behind the suit, and they'll be deeply missed in the movie world. And I mean, if you're looking for that perfect representation of the Predator, this figure, I strongly recommend you guys to get this figure, okay? Okay, guys, thank you for watching. We'll see you guys soon. And yes, remember, October's almost here. Spooktacular is coming, and Halloween and all that stuff. So stay tuned. I'm going to have a full coverage on it through the month of October. And I'm going to have all the high-end horror reviews that I promised you guys and that I did on my preview. You guys take it easy. We'll see you guys soon.